Apple to YMCA Youth Council and this is our journey.
Before I started this project, I thought it was just like a giant joke, like when you see like people like getting caught like in like certain films, you just think it's a laugh.
Well, at the beginning of the project, I originally thought, yeah, drug trafficking, it's gonna be all like guys with guns mooching about and like, yes, I'm a drug dealer, boom, boom, boom.
We thought it was going to be a laugh and a joke because we knew rock all about drug trafficking, or we thought it was people shoving cocaine up people's bums.
So young people identified drug trafficking as something they wanted to learn more about and something that they wanted their peers and other young people to learn about.
Right, okay, first question we need to ask is, what is it you all know about drug trafficking?
Nothing.
Taking drugs in rush hour?
Is drug trafficking like when you get the
guy in a vis jacket, she's like direct traffic. Like that, but with drugs.
What? Lollipop ladies deal drugs now.
Not saying exactly same lollipop ladies, right? Just them guys who got that with traffic.
Is that your serious view? Chris?
Said the one. What's taking drugs in rush hour?
If you're looking for something sensible, then no.
I think it's pretty clear from the last few comments that we don't really know anything.
It was important from day one that the young people did what they wanted on their project, and we kind of let them roll with their own ideas.
Okay, where are we up to it all?
Well, the first thing is like the mother talking to the police officer about her story and that. That's in real life stuff. And then it like puts through a kind of flashback kind of thing, and it's the guy and his family, and they're clearly really poor and struggling for money and that. And then this guy comes up to him and he's like, oh, if you do drug trafficking for me, I'll give you some money. So the guy says, yeah, sure. Then it goes to animation and it shows the guy swallowing drugs and getting given the money for it. He almost gets caught and he thinks about what would happen to his family if he gets caught in that. And he escapes.
Right, so it starts like we have a voiceover going. No, not we don't have a voiceover, but it like flashes upward.
Fulton YMCA. And then we're going to have like interviews popping up with like saying, oh, so what do you know about drug trafficking? And people are going to be like, I don't know anything about drug trafficking. And then it's like,
in the background, I proper reckon we should have a bit of intense music. Just to.
Right, and then after that we get.
No, after that we have the dreamy fade out, so it's like, ooh.
Yeah, and then after that we have Pablo and his family.
Everyone loves Pablo.
So we have Pablo and his family, and they're like, the poor, and he's got his little moustache going, so he can't borrow them. But they're rapping with lives.
And then it goes to.
And Esteban the nasty man. It comes up like, hey, do you want to do something? Hey. And then, yeah, so Pablo's a crook.
When we started doing the actual sessions, the mood at the Youth Council really did change. We were dealing with quite a real situation, quite a real scenario, and I remember after one particular video, just the young people's expressions and their ideas and opinions, they were absolutely devastated at the conditions, the lack of choice, lack of free will. There were links between their lives here in Bolton and those of the Global South.
Basically, we watched this video about how they had no choice in to do anything and how the Colombian government flew over and dropped pesticides on them, which made the children ill, and that's just what made me take it seriously.
Right, okay, what we're going to do tonight, we're going to watch a YouTube clip about drug trafficking. So if you watch it, and then we can answer any questions later and have a discussion about it. Alright?
It was like, you watched it and you thought, wait, this is a really serious man sort of thing.
Okay, after watching that YouTube clip, what are our initial thoughts about drug trafficking and anything that stood out for you people?
Well, it don't really seem like much of a joke anymore.
It kind of shows that it's too good to be true.
Yeah, because they said, didn't they, that they thought, oh, right, well, we're just going to take Sonia, like, tell us off and then we'll be able to go home, but made them watch the plane take off. And
do we think about when they got there that they had a chance? Because when they got there, can you remember what happened when they first got off the plane?
Yeah, when there was just loads of customs officers everywhere.
Now that we've actually learnt more and like looked up facts, and we watched a video called Banged Up Abroad, which was actually about two American girls that had been taken over to drug traffic and their experience and stuff. It taught me a lot. It made it not a joke at all.
Banged Up Abroad.
Hey.
Hiya.
Do either of you two want to make $5,000 each?
What do you mean?
Yeah, it even includes a free trip to Peru. All you have to do is take cocaine back over the border.
Cocaine? Honestly? Just give us a second.
Sure.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, sounds right, yeah.
Meet you at the airport.
Even though you know they're in your suitcase, you think that you're not part of that problem. You're the little footstep of that problem. You're making it escalate. You are the ones that are making the drugs come to the country. You might get him paid and you're not doing the dealing, but you are being used as a mule.
And after this project started, it kind of hit home and realised how terrible things can get. It's not going to happen like the way you think it is. It's going to happen a lot worse and a lot of people's lives can be destroyed.
I did know that it was quite a large consequences for travelling drugs over from country to country, but I didn't know it, that they'd get treated that bad. I personally thought they'd just get locked up, they'd get a fine obviously, and get quite a hefty sentence, but the way they got treated was just unacceptable, and it's like they basically watched their lives disappear.
So what do you all know about drug trafficking now?
Well, for some people it's the only way they can really support families. It might not always be simply American girls just going abroad for a free holiday.
I learned the pesticides they use on the drugs can kill the children in the villages.
I know that the drug trade makes millions more than the diamond trade, and that the growers barely get paid anything.
Countries with the death penalty for drug trafficking include Malaysia, Thailand, Singapore and Iran.
The internal swallowing of drugs can often lead to death or other serious health implications.
In India, smoking cannabis often carries a 10-year sentence.
In 2006, China marked the un-anti-drug day by executing 55 drug dealers in 2 weeks.
I thought I knew a lot more than I did. There were a lot of shocking statistics that I didn't know about.
Since I found out more about drug trafficking, I feel uneducated and ignorant because everything I knew was wrong.
Now that I have learnt about the other people that do get involved in it, like the families who are forced to grow the crops to feed their children, it is like it is a really serious matter, and I do think awareness does need to be raised about it, because there are people that are dying because of it, and it really is something that should be addressed, and people really do need to know about this.